Comfort honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him, so long as you both shall live. If so, answer, I will. To the congregation, will all of you witnessing these promises do all in your power to uphold these two people in their marriage? If so, answer, we will.
We will.
Who is giving this woman to be married to this man?
Our Lord Jesus Christ taught us that at the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this cause, a man shall leave his wife and mother, or his father and mother, and shall cleave to his wife, the two shall become one flesh. Consequently, we are no longer two, but one flesh. You've come to be made husband and wife this day, so as you're joining hands, I need you to repeat these vows after me. David, you're first. I, David, take you, Hannah, to be my wife, have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until we are parted by death. As God is my witness, I give you my promise. Now, Hannah, it's your turn. I, Hannah, take you, David, to be my husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until we are parted by death. As God is my witness, I give you my promise. Paul writes in 1 Corinthians 13 of the kind of love we are to have each for the other. He writes, love is patient, love is kind, and is not jealous. Love does not brag, it's not arrogant, is not acting becomingly, does not seek its own, is not provoked, does not take into account the wrong suffered, does not rejoice in unrighteousness, but rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. Having this love in your hearts, you have chosen to seal your vows by the giving and receiving of rings, so I'll ask that those rings be placed on this book at this time. These rings are a sign of the vows by which this man and woman are binding themselves to one another here this day in our presence. David, if you'll take the ring that you have for Hannah, and as you place it on her finger, repeat after me. I give you this ring as a symbol of my vow, and with all that I am and all that I have, I honor you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Hannah, you take the ring that you have for David, and as you're placing it on his finger, repeat after me. I give you this ring as a symbol of my vow, and with all that I am and all that I have, I honor you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hannah and David have chosen to take a few moments during their special day to join their lives through a unity cord ceremony. The braiding of the three strands that they're making their way to at this time demonstrates how David and Hannah are joined by God in marriage. Each strand holds special meaning. The first strand symbolizes that the Lord Jesus has been invited by David and Hannah to the position of authority in this marriage relationship. The second strand represents the groom. As David loves his wife and submits himself to the Lord in turn will demonstrate his great love in the marriage relationship. And the third strand represents the bride. As Hannah honors her husband and submits herself to the Lord in turn will nurture and strengthen the marriage relationship. At this time, Lexi will read the scripture that this ceremony is based upon.
Ecclesiastes 4:12 states, though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. The cord of three strands is not easily broken.
Today, David and Hannah have been woven together by God as one in marriage. And this brief and unique ceremony that they just took part of represents that fact before our presence this day. Just before I pray with the two of you, I'd like to share a few thoughts that I wrote down in my office right over there earlier this week. And I knew your whole life. I'm one of the two people in this room who can say they saw you the very moment you were born. From the first time I held you in my hands in the delivery room, I knew you were destined for great things. You made me a dad for the first time, and over the years since then, you made me a Disney dad, a dad of a school-age kid, dad of a teenager, and a cheer dad for the very first time. And now today, you made me a father to bride for the very first time. I couldn't be prouder. You've been an absolute joy to raise. It's been a true gift from God, watching you grow into the young woman that you become. Getting to experience life with you, your heart, your passion, your drive, your determination, your smarts, your academic and athletic achievements, and especially your commitment to Jesus, are just some of the many things that I'm proudest of you for. You've blessed me with so many wonderful and unforgettable moments and memories over the past 20 plus years. There's simply too many of them to count. Today is another one of those special moments where we're making more wonderful memories as a family. Today is the day that you dreamed of since you were very young. The day where you're finally the Disney princess who gets to begin her happily ever after. You've definitely chosen a true prince of a fellow in David. I love you, and it's an honor to be able to call you my daughter. David, although I haven't known you quite as long as Hannah, in so many ways, it feels like I have. In the time that I've gotten to know you over these past 6+ years, I've been so impressed by you. Of course, I've been impressed time and again with your basketball skills and your IQ for the game. It's been a real treat getting to watch play ball at the high school and college level. But what I've been most impressed with by you is the patience, the perseverance, the kindness, the integrity, and the thoughtfulness that I've consistently seen you exhibit over the years. These are just some of the character traits that I've watched you live out to go along with your relationship with Jesus that gives me as Hannah's dad peace of heart and mind that she picked not just the right guy, but the very best guy for her to be life with. I love you, David, and just so you know, if I had had a son, I would certainly hope he would have been somebody like I feel like you're already part of the family and haven't for the past few years. If you remember, I told you, when I take you to Disney World, you're in. So you've really been in since 2017, but I'm really proud of the fact that after today, I'll officially be able to call you son. To both of you, I offer this advice. Always keep this relationship that you're embarking on today, the most important one you have, second only to your relationship with Jesus. Always keep the Lord the center of the foundation upon which you build your marriage and your family. Always love each other completely and unconditionally, and make it easy for each of you to always love the other. Always be with and for one another, and when there are issues or problems or disagreements that come up, and they will, make sure you always talk it out, hug it out, and pray it through. The two of you are going to have a wonderful life and a long and happy marriage together. And I'm so very happy and excited for you guys. Now, I would pray that both of you should be able to start this part of your journey and relationship together. God, I want to pray for Hannah and for David right now. What a joy and privilege it is to be able to help them in this way, on this special day, to lead them through these vows, these commitments, these promises that they have made to one another, to love and care and be with and for one another all the rest of the days of their life on this earth. I love each of them so much. and I pray your greatest blessing upon them as they continue to build upon the relationship that they've been building for these last several years. Lord, as they take it to the next level and as they go on to the next chapter and begin their married life together, may you bless them as they build that relationship and that marriage upon you. Go ahead of them and before them and prepare their path. May they always seek your wisdom and guidance in all they do together as a couple. And may they always love each other unconditionally, I pray. Bless them not only this day, but with all years and months and weeks and days, many, many to go ahead. Come and have a long and happy life together, I pray. And I'll thank you for it. In Jesus' name. Now that David and Hannah have given themselves to each other by solemn vow before us before God as witness, and have shown their affection and trust by the giving and receiving of rings and by joining hands, I pronounce by the power entrusted to me by the state of Indiana and as an ordained minister of the Church of God, and yes, as Hannah's man, that they are husband and wife, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. What God has joined together in this moment, this day, may no one ever separate. David, you may kiss the bride. Now join me in recognizing for the very first time Mr. and Mrs. David Froedge.
Thank you. This is the conclusion of our service today, so God bless you all.